I will be performing a modified Knott's heartworm test. I will do this by mixing a 1:9 ratio of anticoagulated blood with saline. So this is 0.1 of uncoagulated blood, and this is 0.9 of sterile saline. And I'm mixing it into a centrifuge tube, which I will centrifuge for 5 minutes at 1,000 to 1,500 RPMs. For my modified Knott's heartworm test, I will be placing the saline and uncoagulated blood into the centrifuge, and I will centrifuge for 5 minutes. I've received my sample that has been spun down through the centrifuge. I'm going to pour off the supernatant, and then with what's remaining in there, I'm going to place a drop of methylene blue stain in there. And I'm going to use my pipette to mix it up. And then I'm going to place a drop of it on my slide with a cover slip. My drop, place my cover slide, and then I'm going to be looking at this under a 10 times power on my microscope. Now that I have it on the 10 power, I'm going to finally adjust it. Yep, there we go. And I'm going to check multiple fields for microfilaria. And I don't seem to see any. So I believe that this modified Knott's heartworm test is negative. I will be performing a direct heartworm test. In order to do this, I will take one drop of whole blood, place it on a slide, and then I will cover that slide with a cover slip, and then go to my microscope. We'll start out on the lowest power. There we go. Moving up to the next one, still a low power, but it's 10 times. And so that comes into focus. I see whole red blood cells, but I see no other kind of microorganism. I'll look through multiple different selections of my blood sample to determine that there is, in fact, no microfilaria, so this heartworm test is negative.